Hi there, my name's Andy Young and I'm one of the automotive lecturers down at Unitech in Auckland, New Zealand, and welcome to my Andy Mechanic YouTube channel. Now, this is the fourth video in a series of four. This is the last one covering the brake overhaul on a 1998 Yamaha TDR250. I've already done videos covering the front master cylinder, the front caliper, the rear master cylinder, and on this particular video I'm going to cover removing the rear caliper, stripping it all down, inspecting it, cleaning it, and building it back up with new components. That'll be new seals, not new pistons, hopefully. And getting it put back on the bike. So here we go. Let's get it pulled off the machine. Okay, so we've already removed the hydraulic pipe off the caliper from the master cylinder. So all that's left to do now is to remove these two mounting bolts. Now, the caliper at the moment is still full of fluid, so I don't want to spill that all over the rear disc. That would be pretty bad. There we go. Now, when we put these bolts back on, they should have thread lock on them, and these don't feel like they have. Well, maybe a very long time ago. It's not doing a lot of good now. They weren't particularly tight. Okay. Right. So now, very carefully, we should be able to just lever that caliper off the disc. There we go. Right, over to the bench. Right, okay, first job's to get all the old brake fluid out, which doesn't really want to come out very well. Now, there was a problem with this caliper. It did leak. It was leaking brake fluid for a while. So we've got to look for some kind of potential problems as well. Maybe if I crack off one of these bleed nipples. It's got two actually on here. That's quite bizarre. Crack off one of these two bleed nipples, or both of them. We'll take them both out actually, it'll be easier. And then that might help some of the fluid to come out. Okay. Right, that's one. That's tight on the threads, is that one? Now, luckily those are both the same, so we don't have to worry too much about that. Okay, let's see if we can get some more fluid out. There we go. It doesn't look the best condition fluid. Brake fluid over time attracts moisture, and moisture is bad for all the components. It also affects heavy braking as well. It can cause the brake fluid to boil too early. It reduces the boiling point, and that can cause some pretty serious loss of braking problems, to be honest. Okay, now, just looking at the caliper. To get these pistons out, this is again a fixed caliper. It's got a piston on either side, which is classed really as quite a high performance kind of piston, kind of caliper. So to remove those pistons, we're going to need to split the caliper, just like we did the front caliper. Before we do that, we'll take the pads out, which is these two bolts here. They're the pins, the retaining pins, so we'll get those cracked off. And then we need to undo these two large bolts here. I think before we do that, we'll give it a bit of a clean, because it's, man, it's dirty, isn't it? Okay, let's do that. Now, it's really important you don't get brake fluid on the brake pads themselves. That can cause contamination, and it does drastically affect the coefficient of friction between the brake pad and the disc itself, and obviously that affects brake performance. So get those pins pulled out first of all and get rid of those pads. So number five Allen key, and I'm going to mount it in the vise now. Okay. One. Two. Excellent. Okay, pull that out. One pin. And the second pin. They're not in bad nick. Excellent. And we get these pads out now. Okay, plenty of meat left on those. And they don't look too contaminated, which is good news. Ben will be very happy. Right. Okay, so next job is to undo these very large 14mm bolts, and that's going to allow us to split that caliper. Okay, one. Two. Excellent. Wow, that's not seen the light of day for probably since it was born, I would say. Okay. Both bolts are the same, so that's good. And then, you can see now, that's called the, this part here where this O-ring is, that's the transfer port. And that's what allows the fluid to flow from this chamber into the second chamber for the outer piston. There we go. Yeah. Pretty grubby, isn't it? Okay, get rid of that. And which way around it goes. It's a little curly bit towards the transfer port. Okay, get rid of the seal. Get a new one of those if we have one. Hopefully we will. There we go. Okay, so what's next? Well, we can give it a bit more of a clean, and then we can get these pistons popped out, and I'll show you how to do that. Okay, so we'll do the outer side first. I think it is, maybe inner. I don't know, one of them. What I've done is I've refitted the bleed nipple, and I've cleaned it up first, made sure it's got a hole in it, and it actually works. It's not all gummed up with the crap that was down there. And I've fitted a bit of an old brake pipe that I have kicking around that I use for this particular job, which has a small piece of the rubber left over of the hose, which means that my blowdown gun can then seal against that. And then, with that sealed off, we should be able to pop the piston out. Now, to seal the transfer port, I've just got a bit of old bicycle inner tube. I'm going to clamp that with a piece of metal plate in the vise. And that's going to seal it off really well. So we'll do that next. Stick that in there. There we go. Cool, that should be enough. Right. Okay, here goes. Now, one of the problems is these things can fly out a long way. So what we'll do before we actually start, because they can come up with quite a bit of pressure, is we'll just install a G-clamp just in there. And that's going to act a bit like a limiter, so it can't fly off and smash into my expensive tripod. There we go, that should be enough. Yeah, it's going to give us about 10 mils of movement first of all. Oh, look at that. A bit more pressure required, that's all we needed. Okay, so now we can just slacken that off a bit more and just do it a bit at a time. I think. There we go, we're out. God, like clockwork. It wasn't too bad at all, was it? And as you're pulling these things apart, it's actually quite a good indication as to you know, the condition of the whole thing. Right. Okay, one piston to clean up. So we can get rid of that. I found a really good way of cleaning these bleed nipples out is to use a small drill bit. This is one that I haven't done yet, and you can basically just run that down there. And oh, there you go, look. A bit more gravel road. These should have little plastic bungs on them, little caps. And this is the problem if you don't put the caps on, they get full of crap. And then when you come to bleed up later on, they don't bleed very well. In fact, they don't bleed at all. Jeez, Benjamin. Mr. Maintenance. Right. Okay, and there should be a hole just there. And there really isn't. Okay. Right, I found it. Bit of wire brushing later. There's your hole, which is tiny. Let's give that a bit of a clean out. And we get the little drill bit again. Oh yeah, you can see the drill bit, that's good. And then if you just blur down the hole, there we go. So by doing that, we know it's definitely clear. Right, we can get back on with the original job of popping that piston out now. How are we gonna do this? So you can see what's going on. I think we'll have to try it like that, won't we? That'll work. Okay, let's see how we get on. Hopefully we won't destroy the old camera. Right, so G-clamp back on again then. Should be fun. Sorry, camera. Very, very close up, close shot. Okay, that's about a bit more. That should be about right. Okay. So going on to the bleed nipple port. Excellent. Not bad at all. Okay, a bit more. There we go. One more turn. Brilliant. Done. Right, well, one piston. Looks like we should be able to clean that up. No signs of rust, that's the important thing. And no deep grooves. Excellent. Okay, so that's the caliper completely stripped down. We've got this, you know, one half here, and we've got the other half just there, look, all stripped, ready to be cleaned up inside the piston, inside the cylinders. And I've got a couple of pistons to clean up as well, so I'll get on with that. And I'll be using, for the pistons, I'll be using some, where is it now? Here we go, look. Some P800 wet and dry, just a little bit, just to get all the marks off and make sure that, you know, we get all the residue and dirt and stuff. And then we can thoroughly inspect those pistons and make sure they're good to be reused. And we're gonna flick out the seals. Do that now, actually. Here we go. So little pick and get that down there. There we go, look, bring that seal out. Not too bad. And then we've got the dust seal, which is the outer one. They're usually a little bit harder to get out because they tend to get really gummed in there. See that in there, look. At this point, oh, broken, look, there you go. Okay, well, hopefully the new ones are going to be the right ones, because that can't go back in again. Buggered. Okay, I'll do the other one as a close-up. Okay, so just removing let's do the main seal first. That's always a lot easier to get out. Just get your little scriber in there. It's always a good idea to have one of these that isn't too sharp. Then you hook around the back and pull it out. There we go. Easy.
and for the dust seal. Just try and get down the side. I'll then hook underneath. There you go. And then we can get rid of that one. And that one's broken as well. Interesting. Okay. Well, Ben did say he had leaks on this caliper, but that's the leaks aren't down to the dust seals. The leaking will be down to the main seal. Okay, well, now that the seals are out, I've got to go around and clean all the residue again, just like on the front caliper, from these grooves. You can see it all, how it builds up. And that buildup of residue and dirt causes a big problem, where it basically reduces the available diameter for that seal to sit in and causes the seal to get pressed against the piston far too much. And that reduces piston retraction and, you know, can cause the brakes to bind on. It's not good. So I'll work my way around on both these calipers, get all these four grooves really clean, ready for the new seals to be fitted. It just takes a bit of time. There's no point in rushing it. You know, it's got to be done. And the better you do it, the longer your caliper is going to last till you've got to do it all over again. Funny, isn't it? Whenever I do this kind of stuff, Ben's nowhere to be seen. Just fix the bike, Dad. Okay, well, I'll carry on with this. I don't think you need to watch me clean all this lot out. But you've got the idea. I'll come back to you once it's all nice and clean. Right, I'm back. So we're all clean now in all those grooves, dust seal groove, main seal groove, on the both halves of the caliper. So that's pretty good. So the next job now is to clean up the pistons themselves. Now, this normally doesn't take too long, and there's a number of different ways you can do it. What I like to do, first of all, is just grab a wire brush and just take the thick off using a wire brush. That won't harm the surface of the piston in any way, because they're usually chromed anyway. And what you're looking for is a scoring or pitting. Pitting is usually caused by corrosion, where there's been water or moisture in the brake fluid, and over a long period of time it's been eating away at the surface. Now that might be, it could also be corrosion around the end here, where the exposed part of the piston has been open to the elements. I mean, on these particular calipers, they only have a, they don't have a dust sort of seal gaiter as such. They just have a seal that remains inside the caliper housing. So any part of the piston that's sticking out of the caliper housing is of course open to the elements, which is actually quite bad design really. So a bit more wet and dry, and all you need to do is just run your wet and dry around the piston like that. This is P800 grit, very very fine, and it just helps to remove any sort of surface debris that's on there, that's built up over time. And it's important these pistons are nice and smooth, otherwise it's going to cause a problem against the seals. It's going to affect piston retraction and overall the operation of the whole caliper really. So it's critical that these things are nice and clean. Hey, that's in good nick. Good. That's one. The reason why I wire brush them first is it just stops your sandpaper clogging up so much with all the crap. Oops. Sorry, brake cleaner. Off, have a little look, see if there's anything obvious. black there, look, but that's far enough out not to worry about it. Okay, same again, Sam. Bloody good, actually. A lot better than I thought it would be. Okay, so that's both pistons now all cleaned up, and we can get those put back in again with the new seals. Right, time for a rebuild, I reckon.
Now that everything's ready and clean for reassembly, it's time to use the new seals, to fit the new seals. Now, that's the part number from Yambits. It's a BCS001. Now, the problem is, Benjamin only ordered one set. And of course, this caliper has two pistons, not the one. Really could have done with another one of these. Maybe you didn't realize it was, you know, a twin piston caliper. Bit of a shame, and it should have said on the website, two required for that particular task. So I can only put new seals in one side. And to compound the problem, both of the old dust seals are in bits. So I can't use those. But they are only dust seals. So he's going to have to order another set of these. And I'm going to have this job to do all over again in a few weeks' time to fit the new seals on the other side. Damn. Oh well, still going to be a good video, not to worry. Right, so I'll show you how to fit these new seals to one side of the caliper. Here we go. Okay. So let's put the new seals on, ooh, which side is that? On the inside, right. Makes no difference at all. Okay. Now what we're gonna need is some brake fluid. Let's get a bit of that. Now it's really important when you're assembling a caliper, you use brake fluid as sort of the build lubricant. What you mustn't do is use oil or grease or rubber grease or anything like that, because it has a different friction coefficient, and it affects the friction coefficient between the seal and the piston, which is bad. Okay, so main seal first, pop that in there and then just follow it around. There we go. Pretty easy. Now on the last little bit, just get a little blunt flat screwdriver or something, a little pointy stick, and you can sit it in there. Now we've got a bit of, what the hell that is? A bit of plastic. Okay, that's gone now. Right. Just check that the seal's sat all the way in correctly, because that's very, very important. Right, dust seal. Right, time for the dust seal. Okay, so start it off at one point, hold it in with your thumb or your finger, and then just follow it around. It's very important to make sure it's seated properly as you feed it in. It's all the way down in the groove, otherwise you'll end up with an excess of seal at the end. It makes it really hard to get it in. Oh, there we go, look. Okay, not too bad. Rub it round that way, it just helps to get it to seat evenly all the way around. There we go. Right, piston time. A bit more brake fluid on there. And that should just pop. Should just pop straight in there. Looks a bit, could be a bit of a tight fit.
Man, I don't know if that seal's the right one. Not doing very well here. Just get rid of the dust seal for a second. Okay. Wow. So there's going to be no dust seals on this caliper. Because I think they're the wrong ones. That was way too tight. Okay. Right. And we're going to have to reuse one of the main seals on the outer half of the caliper. Okay, I've just cleaned it all off, give it a quick check, make sure there's no cuts. Because I've got two of these, so I can just choose the best one if this one's dodgy. But there were no leaks. Well, actually there was a bit of a leak, a lie, but it stopped again. So I think there's a bit of crap trapped in there, which disappeared. Right. A bit more lubrication. Main seal in. Seems weird how the main seal's right, but the dust seal seems wrong. Okay. Maybe we'll try the dust seal again. Looks pretty deep, doesn't it? Okay. One more chance, Mr. Dust Seal. Because it's the wrong one, it'll apply too much pressure, it'll bind on the piston. It'll stop the main seal from retracting that piston back in again properly. Okay. Just seems to stick out a lot further than it should do. You see, there's quite a big step. It's quite a, compared to the main seal, that's a much larger step. Don't like that. Don't like that at all. Nah, it's not going to work. Sorry, Ambits, you failed me. Right, we'll flick that out. Okay. That's how they're supposed to go in, nice and easy. And not having a dust seal isn't a major issue short term, but long term, it's going to allow dirt to get down between the piston and the casting, and it's going to start to affect that main seal. It could cause leaks, only because the main seal is getting contaminated and damaged. Right, next job, put the two halves of the caliper back together.
Okay, so a bit disappointed, to be honest, that we only had one seal kit and not two. That's probably Ben's fault, unfortunately. But the dust seal didn't seem to work very well. It was going to be way too tight a fit. I mean, if you look at that piston, now that it's installed, there's a tiny, tiny gap between the piston itself and the casting. And that dust seal was sticking out about 2.5 mil. Which means if I had managed to get the piston in, it would have been a really, really tight fit. And it would not have retracted properly when you release the brake, causing the brakes to bind on. So that's why I've left them out. I have left them out in the past. It's okay short term. But hey, that dust seal's there for a reason. It's there to keep all the crap out and away from that main seal. So I'll have to let Ben know the bad news. And yes, I'm going to have this job to do all over again when we get the right seals. Maybe we'll buy a genuine Yamaha next time. Thanks, Yambits. Okay. Right, the next job is to find a new O-ring for that transfer port. And then we can get the two halves of the caliper put back together and put it back on the bike. Yes. Oh, when we put the two halves together, let's not forget that little spring there for the pads. That's to stop them rattling. Right, so new O-ring for the transfer port. And then stick the other half on there. Oh, spring. That's what we said, didn't we? Right, now that spring just goes in there like that. There we go. Yep. Perfect. Okay. Bolts. Cool. Okay. So now we need to mount it in the vise and tighten these two up. Easy. Great stuff. Okay, so what's next? Well, we need to put the pads back in and the retaining pins as well. Now, with your brake pads, wherever they make contact with the caliper casting, which is down these sides on this one, they should be nice and clean. So we'll just give that a bit of a clean off. There we go. One. Right, that's a bit of a rough cut. Cool. And we should check the pins as well at the same time. Pretty clean. Just a quick clean up. See how they've worn look. It's not so good. That's gonna hold the pads on the against the disc, maybe. It's going to restrict them moving freely. Should really have new pins, so I'll get Ben to order some of those as well. Right, copy paste on the pins. Just a very thin layer, nothing excessive. Yeah, and on the brake pads themselves,
on those contact points onto the caliper. And, more importantly, on the back where it makes contact with the piston as well. But again, not too much. Great stuff. Now make sure you've got none on your hands, because you don't want to get copper paste on the friction material. That's very, very bad. Right, time to put the pads back in. Now the springs down there, they sit in the middle here, so as you offer that pad down, it should just push that spring down out of the way. There we go. And that's to stop the pads from rattling. Right, now, time for the pins. Just got to put a bit of pressure on the pad. Should be able to guide that pin through. There we go, that's one. Two, right, number five, Allen key. Super job. Now, they don't need to be too tight. Right. Just double check my copper paste on the pad. Right, I just want to double check these are nice and tight too. Our special tool number 37B. That can come out. Use that for next time. Good stuff. Okay, so that's our caliper completely rebuilt, reassembled with new main seals, no dust seals. Terrible, isn't it, really? Such is life. Okay, well, it's not a hard caliper to do, and it'll give me something to do over Christmas. As if I haven't got too much to do. Okay, so let's head back to the bike, and we'll get this bolted back on, and then I can bleed it up. Now, I'm not going to cover the bleeding process on this video. I've already made loads of videos covering how to bleed up brakes, and it's the same principle for bleeding the rear brake on the Yamaha TDR 250. No difference. Okay, so let's head back to the bike and get it bolted on. Okay, so making sure we've got one right around, Andy, one pad either side of the disc, and then we can line up these bolts. Now I've already put some thread lock on there. It's very important on caliper mounting bolts that you have thread lock on there. Right, get these done up. Very awkward with the camera in the way. Okay, one, two, right. Now, because I've also reconditioned the master cylinder for the rear brake, the flexi hose is currently off, so I'll refit that now. Right, through there, banjo bolt on, new washers, other way up. Okay, I can do that. There we go, it's more like it. Excellent stuff. Okay, done.
Okay, well there you go. That's the last in the series of four videos covering the brake overhaul of a motorcycle, basically. In this case, a Yamaha TDR250. Video one was the front master cylinder. Video two was the front caliper. Video three, the rear master cylinder. And this video being the rear caliper. And each component's been fully stripped, cleaned, inspected, and rebuilt with whatever new parts we can get our hands on, and unfortunately having to use one or two of the old parts as well. But overall, not too bad a job. Quite happy, really, overall, on how things have gone. Things could have been a much, much worse. But each component was reconditionable, which is the important thing, because trying to find parts for this particular bike now, they're very, very difficult to find. And new parts, components, like a master cylinder, very, very difficult to get hold of. Okay, well, my name's Andy Young, and I'm one of the automotive lecturers down at Unitech in Auckland, New Zealand. And you've been watching my Andy Mechanic YouTube channel. Hope you found the video helpful. If you did, then why not subscribe to the channel? Click subscribe wherever it is, somewhere around there. And then you'll see a little gear icon. Click on the gear icon and turn on notifications. And that way, you'll get an email whenever I upload any new videos, and hopefully some of those will also be of help to you. Now, as regards communication, if you've got any questions for me, first port of call, please, through YouTube on the comments, but you can also communicate with me through Facebook. You'll find me on there, Google+, Instagram, and of course, Twitter as well. So again, you can use those if you like, but first port of call, first contact through YouTube, please, because that's the main place that people look for questions and answers. Okay, well, that's it for now. Cheers, thanks, over and out.